Okay, guys. Hey, this is on Significant Figures. How's it going? Mr. Lundberg here. This is on Significant Figures and why Significant Figures. And so the reason why we have Significant Figures is because we use tools. Here's a couple rulers to measure things. And one of the things you'll notice is if I use this particular device to measure the diameter, the diameter of of this, a particular circle, here we have, it measures in halves. So we have one, one and a half, two, it's not quite two and a half. And so we have to estimate where it is between the two and the 2.5 centimeters. So I would think, so there's one, we know for sure it's two. So I put a two in this box. And it's also kind of halfway between there, but I would say it's probably, we can only guess to the 0.1 of a centimeter here. So I'm going to guess a 2. Can't say 2.5 because, and it looks like it might be 2.5, but I can't guess that because this instrument only measures 2 plus or minus a centimeter, a 0.1 of a centimeter, excuse me. And so when you look at this, that's what we're going to get. So if I submit this, correct, here it says this measurement contains two significant figures and one of those digits is uncertain. Well, the uncertain digits is this. We don't know if it's a 2 exactly. It could be a 3. And so it's got two significant figures. One is for sure and the other one is uncertain. So significant figures takes care of uncertainty for us. Now watch what happens if I take the same circle and go to a different tool for measuring. This one is... I'm not here on the exact center. Let me keep coming down right there. That looks pretty good. So now when we can look at this, we can know for sure it's 2. We now know for sure it's 0.2. So we've got that. And then our last one, we can go one more digit here and we can estimate that. That's what this digit, the uncertain digit, is for estimating. So I'm going to estimate that. That's probably, it could be 8 or it could be 9. I'm not exactly sure, but so I'm going to put in, I'll put a 9 here. It might be 9, so I'll submit that, see what happens. So it is. So I can use that. What if I would have put an 8 there? Would have been okay, because it's plus or minus one significant figure at the end, just like this one, plus or minus one, we don't know. It could have been a 3. If I would have put 3, it probably would have accepted it up here as well, because we didn't know for sure whether it was 2 or whether it was 3. This I don't know for sure, whether it's 9, I don't know for sure what this one is. So it's plus or minus that significant figure that's there. So 2.29 works. If I would have put 8, 2.28 also works, and I would have gotten the correct answer for that. So that's kind of neat. So that's significant figures, and that's why we use them. It's because of the different types of tools that we're using to measure with that we can end up doing that. Let's go to